In this video, I'm going to share with you 8 effects built into Adobe Premiere Pro that you can start using in your videos today. And number one is the use of Ken Burns. This is really popular when it comes to YouTubers, and it's really simple inside of Adobe Premiere Pro. Let me show you exactly what I'm talking about, and then I'll show you how to do it. Let's get right into this video. So this is the Ken Burns effect right here. I'm gonna press play, and you get this zoom effect. So to do this, you might have a stabilized clip. Maybe you had it on your tripod, or probably an image you shot, and you just want to animate the clip to create the moving sequence. So I've created a sequence here, and I'm going to animate this photo, and I want to go to my effects control tab. If I hit shift 5, there it is up here on the left. I'm going to move the playhead all the way to the beginning, and under motion I'm going to click on the stopwatch for position and scale, and that's going to create 2 keyframes right at the beginning. So now I'm going to move the playhead over to where I think I want the effect to end, and I'm going to adjust the Y value of the position and the scale to make my effect how I want it. And I'll play this, see how it looks. And I think I want to change my position, bring this over a little bit, and we'll play that again. What you can do to make this look smoother at the end is you can select both of these keyframes, right click, go to temporal interpolation, and go to ease in. So we can adjust these keyframes in. I'm gonna select them both here and bring them in closer, and the effect will happen sooner. Hit play, and if I select these again and move the keyframes out, it's gonna take the effect longer. There we go. And that's the Ken Burns effect. And here's an example of how the swoosh in and out would look. Comes from the left all the way up to the right very quickly. So to make our swoosh in and swoosh out text, I've created my sequence and added this clip to the timeline. And now I'm going to get the text tool and come over here to the program monitor and just start typing in. Type in the word volcano, and I can use the essential graphics panel to make my text larger, you know, and make sure that it is left aligned over here. And I'm just gonna grab it and position it somewhere around here. So like I say, you can use the essential graphics panel to do anything you need to the text, change the font and add a little space in between my letters here. First, I'm gonna make this text layer a little bit longer. I'm gonna move my playhead about 1 second and click on my position stopwatch. Here's my first keyframe. I'm going to bring my playhead out about 3 seconds and click the diamond right here to add another keyframe. Here's our second keyframe. And I'm going to take the playhead all the way to the beginning and change my value to make the text go off of the screen completely to the left. Then move the playhead out, say 4 seconds, and then move the text all the way off the screen to the right. And let's just play this. And to make that text go across there a lot smoother, I'm gonna select these 2 keyframes in the middle and right click and go to temporal interpolation and go to continuous Bezier. Now if we come over here to this arrow next to position, you can see we have this graph here. Make this a little bit bigger and select that keyframe and grab the first one and drag and hold to the left. Bring that down and select the other keyframe and drag, bring that down to the right. And let's run this again. And you can add some sound effects here, but there you have it, our swoosh in and out. Here's what our before and after example would look like. With the before and after effect, you're basically going to be utilizing layers. And this clip is going to be the before clip, and we're gonna make a copy of it and put that above it for the after clip. Now select this clip, hold down Alt or Option, and drag up, and there is my copy. So the after clip is going to be different than the original clip. So let's say I applied some kind of effect in this case. I'll go to the Lumetri color panel, and I'm going to make sure I'm on the top layer here because that is my after. I'm going to come up here to creative look, and I'm going to find SL gold orange. Apply that to my top layer here, and I'm going to adjust my shadows here a little bit and highlights, bring those down a little bit. So let's say I wanted to showcase the difference. Just to make things even more apparent, I'll go to the original clip and I'll desaturate it all the way. So we're going from a desaturated clip to a color graduated clip in an animated way. So I'm selecting the bottom clip here, and I'll take the saturation all the way down. Let me turn this off. So saturation is completely off on the lower clip. And so one really simple way is to go into the effects panel, open up the video transitions, and find the wipe transition. So now I want to come to my effects and search for wipe. Under video transitions, here is the wipe effect. But first I want to crop in my clip to the point where I want to start to see the after effect. And I'll just guess anywhere right there. Then I'm going to drag my wipe effect onto the front of the clip. And you can stretch this out to make the animation go slower. And here's our before and after effect. And here's the wipe effect. And there it is. So for our pop-up text, we need a clip that we are going to make the text pop up on. And so this is kind of the clip I'm going to use.
So something I want to pass on to you is keep playing guitar.
So I'm going to pop up those words, keep playing guitar. So the first thing we need to do is get our text tool and type in the words in our program monitor. And so I've already created my text. And so you just need to type it in the way you want it to look in the end. You can use the essential graphics panel to make your text bigger, change your font. So this is how I want it to look at the end. So now I need to work on how I'm going to pop in each of these words and when it's going to happen. So I'm going to create a mask for each of those words. First, what I want to do with my text layer selected, I want to make a cut on my timeline here, each place where I want the text to pop in. So on the word keep
going, so something I want to pass on to you is keep.
So I want a cut there,
playing,
cut there,
guitar,
and guitar. So I will have three small clips here on this text track. So now I'm going to create a mask around each word. So I have three clips here. So on each clip, I'm going to make a mask, each clip representing each of the three words. I'm going to delete this part of the timeline right here that I don't need. This has words that are constantly going to display. I don't need that. I'm going to highlight the first clip. I'm going to bring my playhead over onto that clip. I'm going to come here in the effects control panel, and right here where it says opacity, I'm going to get my pen tool, click on that. I'm going to actually highlight mask path right here, and I'm going to draw my mask. It could be loose. There's one. I'm going to highlight the next clip and bring my playhead over, go over to my pen tool. I like mask path, and I'm going to mask out the word playing. There we go. And I'm going to highlight my third word or the third clip, bring my playhead over, select my pen tool, highlight my mask path, and I'm going to draw my pen path around here. So now when I play it back,
keep it going. So something I want to pass on to you is keep playing guitar.
And there's our pop-up text. If you're getting value out of this so far, hit that like button. Next is the censor effect. Now you can use this to blur out faces, license plates, brand names on any object. So let's see how this is going to look. So this man is drinking some beer here, and I'm just going to blur out the glass of beer in his hand. So this is how it's going to look. Okay, so I'm going to start off here with this unaltered clip. I've already made my sequence and put this clip on the timeline. I'm going to go over to my effects panel and search for something called mosaic. And down here under video effects, under stylize, here is mosaic. Drag that onto my clip. So now you can see in the program monitor that the effect has covered my entire clip. I'm going to go over here to my effects control tab under mosaic. You can adjust this block size. The larger the block size, clearer you can see what's underneath. I'm going to choose something like 40 for horizontal and 40 for vertical. So now I'm going to add a mask under mosaic. There is the different ways that you can create a mask. You can create an ellipse, polygon, or you can draw your mask with the pen tool. I think I'll use the pen tool. I'm just going to get an idea roughly where to draw this. And I'm just going to drag these points to get it in here a little bit more. So this will be my initial mask here. And now under mask one over here in my effects control, I'm going to click on mask path, click on the stopwatch. And there's my first keyframe. And now moving the playhead from the program monitor, and I'm just gonna move it up there, then move up my mask little by little. Each time I change my playhead, I can move up my mask. It's creating keyframes, and I can move very slightly. He's drinking, now he's putting it down, keep on repositioning it. I didn't have to make that many small movements, but that's just to show you how it's tracking. And if I want to play it back to see what happens, there it's tracking the glass of beer as he drinks. And when you're playing it back that way, sometimes you'll see an area that maybe you need to adjust. You can just move your playhead over, and it's better if you're in the program monitor when you do it, and just reposition your mask in the area that you want to take care of. So that's the censor effect. Now we're going to create a video overlay effect. Let's see how that looks. So we're going to use an adjustment layer. So I'm going to turn off the adjustment layer. There's the clip underneath. And with the adjustment layer, we're creating our overlay. And that's how it can look. I'm going to start with this clip on my timeline right now. And I'm going to get a new adjustment layer. And these are the dimensions of my timeline right now. So I'm going to say OK and put the adjustment layer over my main clip and make it the same length. I'm going to go to my effects panel and search for something called ramp. And under video effects, generate, here's ramp. And I'm going to drag it onto my adjustment layer, and it covers my clip. And I'm going to come over here to my effects controls, and the ramp effect is right here. Now here's something called the start color. Click on that. I'm going to click on the yellow here and get something bright. Say okay. And the end color, I'll click on that, and maybe I'll get something like an orangish color. I click okay. And so they're blended together very nicely up here. And when we come down here in our ramp effect, there's something called blend with original. And all the way to 100% is the image. And so in between is something how you could decide what you like. You could change the ramp shape to radial or linear. And now let me play this back. And there you have it. This is how you create a video overlay in Premiere Pro. Now here's something we've probably all done when we're making videos, is the mic that we're using. If it's an overhead mic like this, a lot of times it's coming into the shot. I've over exaggerated it here. A lot of times it's maybe this far into the shot, but let's see how we can get this out of here. So the first thing that we might get is something called a clean plate. So a clean plate is something like a still, but in this case it was just a short clip that I did. I wasn't sitting there and the mic wasn't in the frame at all. And so this is going to be a reference point we're going to use later. So this technique works best if the camera is not moving. So now what we need to do is go to the effects controls, and here under opacity, depending on where your object is coming into the frame, you can choose any of these different tools. I'm going to choose to draw this path myself. So I'm just going to draw something in here. Here's my path. I'm going to hit the feather right here and pull this out a little bit. It's the same as using the mask feather over here in the effects control. And then I'm going to click the inverted checkbox right here. And now here is where I'm going to use this clean plate clip that I made earlier. I'm going to drag that on top of my main clip. Here's a portion of the clip where the mic is no longer in the frame. I'm not even sitting there. With that top track selected, if I hit Shift E, this export frame dialog comes up. Now I want to make sure that the format is PNG, import into project is checked, and this is just going to be a still or one frame that I'm going to use as my clean plate. I'm going to say okay. Now I'm going to remove that clip that was on top. I don't need that. And I'm going to move my main clip up one track, and I'm going to get the still that I saved. It's over my project panel, and drag it underneath my main clip and increase the size. And see, I can play this back. And this is where I was looking at the mic coming down in the clip. And so it's gone. So that's how you could remove an object. So here is face tracking, and this is what it looks like. As I move my face around, the camera tracks with me. So I'll show you how to do this. So to start off with our face tracking, we're going to need a reference point to help us track our face movements. So on my timeline here, I have my clip, and to help with that reference point, I've created a text layer on top of my clip with an X on it. And right away, what I'm going to do is I'm going to zoom in a little bit on my face here. I'm going to go to my X on my text layer and kind of center that in the middle of my face. And now I'm going to highlight my clip on the track below and come over here to motion in the effects control. Click on my position, click on the stopwatch, and that is my first keyframe. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through and hit my arrow key, moving the playhead a couple of frames and see what happens here. Not too much. And I'm going to advance this till I get there. There's a good movement right there. And so now I use my X and Y coordinates over here to line the X up there in the, at the top of my nose. And there's another keyframe. Go up another couple of frames, make another adjustment, and I'll keep on doing this, positioning it either with the X or the Y. And I got some pretty drastic movements here, so that'll be kind of interesting. And it could get kind of tedious, I guess, but put on some headphones and take your time. Yeah, I got some good movements here. Just getting the middle of that mark every couple of keyframes, and just keep on clicking on the arrow key to advance the frames and recenter your mark, and keep going as long as you would like and keep that centered. I'm going to speed this up a bit. There seems to be enough to show you what this is going to look like now. And if I play this back, here's the face tracking, and there we go. You can see all the keyframes that were created up here in the effects control panel. One way to do your face tracking. If you want to know more about Premiere Pro, click or tap on one of the videos on the screen now. If you haven't already, subscribe, like, and share this video. Thanks for watching, and remember, it's never too late to learn. See you in the next video.